is that our Zoom Sunday school starts at 7:30 every Sunday, and our on-site Sunday school services at 8:30 every Sunday. Teen church, 8:30 on-site every Sunday, and the blanket drive has started. We have a few blankets. We please need a few more blankets. Please support this cause. When you sometimes still feel cold. Now, if you think of people who are living on the streets, who are living in shelters who don't have a blanket, please let that be a motivation for you to please bring blankets. We would really support your, appreciate your support in that for the less fortunate. The nomination forms for three more society stewards on the welcome desk. Nominations will run for the month of June. And it will close on 3rd of July. Interviews will be held in the first 2 weeks of July. Be on leave from the 1st of June to the 30th of June. On the 3rd of July, we do everybody's birthday celebration. Yes, that we can have the welcome to Cineval and baptism taking place. We had a 2-year break. And keep the youth in our prayers. So as
on this day, a glorious day on which we are doing quite a number of things for things that we have not managed to do in the past 2 years because of COVID. And we are here today to baptize children into the church. We have a confirmant. We have to also confirm and baptize. And we have members who will be welcomed into Sinoville. I take this time to really say thanks be to God for all that we have done, for the prayers that we have offered, and for all the blessing that we are doing in the whole world. May the Lord keep on blessing us. We are going to take the call to worship and we read together as we know. And let me welcome the friends and families who are new, who have worship, who are coming to worship with us today. Enjoy yourself. Wherever there is white, we all read together. Whether there is another color that is a bit funny, I will be reading alone. Let us read together. How wonderful and beautiful when brothers and sisters get along. It is like costly anointing oil flowing down Aaron's head and beard, flowing down the collar of his priestly robe. It's like the dew of Mount Hermon flowing down the slopes of Zion. Yes, that's where God commands the blessing and ordains eternal life. We will rise and we sing together. We raise our voices to praise the God and we praise the Lord Jesus Christ. All hail the power of Jesus' name. We rise and we sing like we've never sang it before. Of Christ as light in the world.
We read together.
Almighty God, may this candle ignite the light of Jesus rising in glory and dispel the darkness in our hearts and minds. May the water of baptism confirm our baptism in the Holy Spirit. God in three persons, accept this candle and the light of your truth. Guide us to your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Most gracious God, in the abundance of your love, welcome us in your presence You cleansed us by the water from your side and purified us with your blood. Thank you for your mercy and unconditional invitation to be part of your body. Help us to love and welcome the people you called today. Inspire us to praise and worship your holy name together. Remain standing and we sing again. 10,000 reasons we have to praise the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
Our sins are too heavy to carry, too real to hide, and too deep to undo. Forgive what our lips tremble to name, what our hearts can no longer bear, and what has become for us a consuming fire of judgment. Set us free from past that we cannot change. Open to us a future in which we can be changed, and grant us grace to grow more and more in your likeness and image, through Christ Jesus, the light of the world. Amen. Brothers and sisters, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. I would like you to now listen from here until we do the baptism, the welcoming, and the confirmation, that you confirm it within your heart, that you speak it from your heart, and you allow your spirit to unite with the Spirit of God, so that we become one with God and with Christ and the Holy Spirit in us and with us. Will you nurture and encourage all those who we are baptizing, confirming, and welcoming into our midst? You may be seated, and as we give, these people we are receiving today are giving of themselves. Their parents are giving to the church, are giving to God, and I pray that we will give today in response to the grace that we have received in Christ. We will sing Melipiluli Moya, it's just the first one, and the chorus. We sing this one repeatedly until we finish giving, as we will be doing that. Melipiluli Moya Botoka Ufela. Rakadugai. Amen. Let us pray. Modimo Arunanta Tamatla Wose, we thank you for this morning. Reholebuhala Horwana, Modimia Utwandi Tapelo, Modimia Bona, why easy leading pockets and Modim as we give them to you. Reholebu Hamodimo Aruna, Recopas Natasis in the Salahodimo, Reparasa Boholbaha, Horribula de Matlahaho. Talamayaha Homoharehadin Potten as ever to Bahaba Fan and Gazona. Let your spirit multiply, Lord Jesus, not only these gifts, but there where your people have taken. There are those who are praying, there are those who are crying, there are those who are lamenting, but there are also those who are giving thanks to you and glorifying you. Hear each and every one of us and reward us according to the way of your grace, the riches of your grace and mercy. We give to you, Lord Jesus, not that we are expecting anything in return, but knowing that in the glorious, gracious holiness and abundance of your favor, you gave to us your Son Jesus Christ, who died and gave us eternal life. Bless each and every one of us. Bless our families. Bless our children, Lord. Bless our schools and bless all the places where you have called your name upon. And bless us, Lord Jesus, as we do this work. All who are counting, all who are giving, all those who will be using this money to give it to your Lord, to use it to the glory of your word. And we bless this when we pray this in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We may be seated. We are going to take the scripture reading. We're reading from the Old Testament. First Samuel chapter 16. We read verse 16, and we read from verse 1 to 13. I am a bit. Jesu more. Amen. Samuel anoints David. The Lord said to Samuel, "How long will you mourn for Saul, since I have rejected him as king over Israel? Fill your horn with oil and be on your way. I'm sending you to Jesse of Bethlehem. I have chosen one of his sons to be king." But Samuel said, "How can I go? If Saul hears about it, he'll kill me." The Lord said, "Take a heifer with you and say, 'I've come to sacrifice to the Lord.' Invite Jesse to the sacrifice and I will show you what to do. You are to anoint for me the one I indicate." Samuel did what the Lord said. When he arrived at Bethlehem, the elders of the town trembled when they met him. They asked, "Do you come in peace?" Samuel replied, "Yes, in peace. I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Consecrate yourself and come to the sacrifice with me." Then he consecrated Jesse and his sons and invited them to the sacrifice. When they arrived, Samuel saw Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord's anointed stands here before the Lord." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not consider his appearance or his height, for I have rejected him. The Lord does not look at the things people look at. People look at outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart." Then Jesse called Abinadab and had him pass in front of Samuel. But Samuel said, "The Lord has not chosen this one either." Jesse then had Shammah pass by, but Samuel said, "Nor has the Lord chosen this one." Jesse had 7 of his sons pass before Samuel, but Samuel said to him, "The Lord has not chosen these." So he asked Jesse, "Are these all the sons you have?" "They're still the youngest," Jesse answered. "He is tending sheep." Samuel said, "Send for him. We will not sit down until he arrives." So he sent for him and had him brought in. He was glowing with health and had a fine appearance and handsome features. Then the Lord said, "Rise and anoint him. This is the one." So Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon David. Samuel then went to Ramah. And this is the word of the Lord. The next reading we get from the Gospel according to Matthew chapter 3. You're looking at Luke. Sorry. We are reading Matthew. I'm not just who I am. Matthew 3, we're going to read Matthew 3, verse 8 up to verse 16. Matthew 3, 8 to 16 is what I'm going to be reading here. And it reads as follows. "Produce fruit in keeping with repentance. Do not think you can say to yourself, 'We have Abraham as our father.' I tell you that out of these stones, God can raise up children for Abraham. The axe is already at the root of the trees, and every tree that does not produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but after me comes one who is powerful than I, whose sandals I'm not worthy to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor, gathering his wheat into the barn and burning up the chaff with unquenchable fire." Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John. But John tried to deter him, saying, "I need to be baptized by you. And do you come to me?" "I need to be baptized by you. Do you come to me?" Replied Jesus, "Let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this to fulfill all righteousness." Then John consented. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, "This is my son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased." And this is the gospel according to Matthew and the word of God.
Thank you, God. Amen.
I will call Daniel to the front to come and call the names of those who are to be baptized. We start first with those who are to be baptized today. stand there, okay. Just the other side of the rail.
Okay. The parents of baby Mashlate Jordan Mamabolo. The parents of Khumolebo Mashlanga. The parents of Khwetsamedi Kholaganya Moabi. The parents of Katlego Monielo. The parents of Onatile David Tsembla. The parents of Hobalale Lishle Seroka. The parents of Nala Mduduzi Seroka. The parents of Puri Lindukushle Seroka.
That is one. Yeah, and then she's giving me the other list. Oh, this one that I can. Having a problem with baptism. Don't think you have a choice today. You have to respond, you will respond. There's going to be a time when the parents are going to be responding and the time that I will be baptizing the children. So let's just be take note of those different places where we are going to be doing this. A service of baptism and a service of confirmation and a service of welcoming is a service of, it's a public service that has to be done in the church, in the presence of the congregation, because it is a confirmation and affirmation and a commitment to the Church of Christ. And the church is us, is the community gathered here, and the universal church, and the church that is in heaven and the church that is to come. So if you ask these ladies and brothers and who are here, who have come through, they will be able to maybe confirm what we have said, because we have read in the scriptures in different places where we have been doing this. Eternal God, when nothing existed by chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those in the ark through water. You saved your people from Egypt through the sea and brought their children through the Jordan to the land which you promised. In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus, nurtured in the waters of the womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit and bless this gift of water and those who will receive it. Wash away their sin and clothe them in righteousness throughout their life, that dying they may be raised with Christ, they may share in his eternal final victory. The parents are going to make the vows. We do not have anybody who is doing the vow on themselves. We have everybody who is still very young and who have not yet come to the of age where they can make a baptism. So we are doing in baptism of infant and young people. We don't have adults who are baptizing today, okay? So everybody will be represented. Can you just move? Let us try and observe. Let the families stick together. But everybody else, stay away from another one. Just, Mam Chemla, move a little bit this side. Komozo, go there. Okay, go a little bit there. Let's try and observe this. Yeah. Can we move the camera guy? Sorry, Dad. Can you come together and move a little bit to the side? That side, to that side. Yeah, I don't want her very close to you, but I want her close to the husband. Yeah, I stand on in, but so I'm moving. I don't know why.
I'm going to be
reading to all of you, but if you will see that the answer says, I will. I want you to make a commitment yourself, but I'm going to read to all of you at the same time, but you answer in singular. You take your responsibility for what you are doing today. You have brought these children to be baptized and will receive them again to be trained in the teachings, privileges, duties of Christian faith. Will you provide your child a Christian home of love and faithfulness? Will you help your child by your words, prayers, and example to reject all evil and to put his or her trust in Jesus Christ, his or her Savior and Lord? Will you encourage him or her to enter into full membership of the church and serve Christ in the world? Now this goes to the congregation, members of the body of Christ who now in his name receive these children. Will you maintain the common life of worship and service that they and all children amongst you may grow in grace and in the knowledge and love of God, our parent, Jesus, the Son, and the ever-present Holy Spirit? Are you the first in line? Now, just step a little bit forward. Move to this side. I'm not going to be taking the children from the parents for all reasons of COVID-19. Ne? I'm not going to take you away, but I'm going to sprinkle you with water. I'm staying my kids already done today, you know. I'm not sure what's going on. Just name the child. What is her name? Simengaye. Kisani. Simengaye Tisang. Ke a go kolobetsa lebitso la ntate lebitso la mora le lebitso la moya o halalelang. Amen. I know she, you wait first, and then I'm going to do the handling of the candle now. I'm not going to wait until we are at the end. Okay, so Sunday school. This is the cradle roll. Guy who keeps the cradle roll, who follows our children around. If you want to know anything about the children, his name is Oki. So Oki knows every child here. Oki continues with the children even after we have baptized them finished. May the Holy Spirit work within you, that being through this water and the Spirit, you will become a faithful disciple of Christ. Amen. Amen. You may be, you just stand on the side and the candle. The next. Just call the names, because now they, I thought they're standing in the way that they're supposed to be standing.
Okay. Mashlatsi, Jordan, Mamabolo.
Can you call Mashlatsi's name? Mathasi Gordon, Jordan. Oh, you are the Jordan, the river. That's why you cry so easily. Mathasi Jordan, I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And Mathasi will get the candle. May the Spirit of God dwell in you so that you will become a faithful servant and disciple of Christ. Amen. Bye-bye. This guy can cry.
Homo lemo, Mashlanga.
Can you unpack this line? Homo lemo. I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. I give you the sign that you now belong to Jesus Christ, and may the Holy Spirit dwell in you, that you will become a faithful servant of God. Amen. This candle, you keep, you light, you can keep it as an anniversary, but it's not a birthday candle. The candle that you used to pray, a candle that you will really cherish for the rest of your life. And there is a booklet for you. Okay.
Khoitsebedi Moabi.
Khoitsebedi Moahi. Kimani Bisalahai. This is the one name that I struggled to call. Throughout when we had the meetings, I could not call this name. I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. And I give you the sign as a symbol that you now belong to Christ, and that the Spirit of God will dwell in you forever. Amen. Yeah. The man is Jordan. Okay, kholagano, a covenant.
Katlego, Moniello.
Give her the name. Hey, you are dressed for the part, yeah? what's his name? Katlego, ke go kolobetsa line ntate, line la mora, line la moya, o witshepo. I give you this sign as a symbol that you now belong to Christ. And may the Holy Spirit dwell in you, that you will become a faithful disciple of Christ. Amen. Yeah, there is a suit guy.
Untatile mchimbla.
Untatile, I baptize you. If it's on Lantate, if it's on Lamora, if it's on Lamaya Uhana, I gave you this sign as a symbol that now you belong to Christ and that the Spirit of God will dwell in you and make you a faithful disciple of Christ. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Let's go read it yourself, my boy. Ne? Sorry.
Hobalale Saroka Enala Saroka.
Give her the name or him the name. Hobalale Lise. I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. And I give you this sign as a symbol that now you belong to Christ and that the Holy Spirit will dwell with you and make you a faithful disciple of Christ. Amen. And then the next one. Nalam Tuduzi, I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. I give you this sign as a symbol that you now belong to Christ and that the Holy Spirit will dwell in you, that you become a faithful disciple of Christ. Amen. First voice, Lindo. No, Lindo must be baptized first again. Lindo? Your name? Linda Kutle? Linda Kutle Pori, you have all of it, and it's on Landate, it's on Lamora, it's on Lamoya Ohananelang. I give you this symbol, the sign today as a symbol that you now belong to Christ and that the Holy Spirit will live in you and make you a disciple of Christ, a faithful disciple of Christ. Amen. I think we have come to that the Holy Spirit will dwell in you and make you a faithful servant of God. The next slide. As we handle the candles to you, we do this commitment and the congregation will answer. Let your light shine so that others seeing your good works may glorify God who is your parent in heaven. Amen. Go in peace and the peace of the Lord with you. I just want to say this, that I think you heard me calling the name. The parents gave me Lindogu Tesiroke, but I just said Lindogu. We are baptizing the person themselves. We are baptizing them into the name of the Father. Some people later change names and do all kinds of things, but we baptize that person that is within you. It's never going to be taken away. So we baptize that person. So you're welcomed into the church, and we will Can the next slide come? Let me just see whether we are not. Okay, we're doing the confirmation here. Lindo, Lindo, come forward. Lindo was like me last year when she was doing the baptism. She had a bereavement in the family and she had to go away to the bereavement. Your grandma, a grandmother passed away last year. So we are confirming her today. She has done the confirmation last year. We just did not confirm her last year. So we're doing today the confirmation, which is not going to be a lot of things that we will do. Through confirmation, you, yeah, you face me. Stand nicely. Oh, okay, you can blow the candles for now. I'm not sure why they did not make, normally they make this small little sleeve around it, so the thing drips there. Sorry about that. I just want to do you so that I can we can dismiss with the same time. Through confirmation, Lindo, through confirmation, you reaffirm your faith and renew the covenant of your baptism. You acknowledge that God is doing for you and affirm what God is doing for you. And you affirm your commitment to Christ's body, the church, the Holy Church. Lindo Kutla, on behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you repent of your sins and reject all evil powers in this world? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist all sin? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in Christ's grace and promise to serve him as your Lord? By confirmation, we receive Lindo Kutle Seroke into Christ's flock and full membership of Sinoville Methodist Society, Mahali Seket in the Methodist Church of Southern Africa in the connection. We pray that you will not be ashamed to keep the Christian faith in Christ crucified, fight against evil in all its form, and persevere as Christ's faithful steward and servant forever. Let the congregation please respond. Amen. We will also hand the Bible to Lindo. And the certificate is here. Let me not give you the closed envelope. Just now you come back and you say you didn't see anything inside. May this Bible be a symbol of God's blessing to you. Hold it tight to his teachings and promises for a good life, full of love, joy, and contentment. May you always stay strong in your faith and trust in God's plan for you and his church. And there is the Bible. There's the only thing we give people in the church is the Bible. So there is all riches in the Bible, and here is your certificate. We thank God for you, and we bless you that you will grow into a young Christian that will blossom and glorify God in all that you do with your life. Amen. Can we then, I'm going to have a lot of people here if I'm not doing. Can we then have, you call the people who are being, go, you can go back to your place. Thank you, Lindo. Can we call the people who are, they must just stand almost close to, that corner, the other, how many are they? If the others can go that side and the others can stand on this side so that we have a little bit of a spread.
Okay. Can we please?
I never said they got it. How?
Can we please call the following people to come up front? Irene Mashlanga, Solly Mashlanga, Nozi Chauki, Vuyani Mlati, Babalwa Mlati, Kedu Baloy, Walter Baloy, Jerry Molokwani, Try Molokwane, Mondi Magatla, Rebone Magatla, Sandra Mabunda, and Tommy Smith.
No, the others must remain that side. Remain that side so they can have a spread. 2, 4, 6 can have another. So the one, Tommy, come this side. Move a little bit back. I'm not discriminating against them, I'm just trying to keep the distance. You join the society, the Centerville Methodist Society, as a baptized and professing member of the Christian faith. As members of Centerville Methodist Society, will you faithfully practice in its ministry by your prayers and presence, your gift, service, and witness? I also wanted you to answer alone. Members of the household of God, I commend these persons to your love and care. Will you do all in your power to help increase their faith, confirm their hope, and perfect them in love? Can we all raise our hands towards each and every, the baptized, the confirmed, and the welcome, the congregation, please raise your hands. The God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, establish you and strengthen you, that you may live in grace and peace. We are all now going to confess the faith. We standing in front here and everybody seated in this church, it is important for us to remember what is it that we are believing in. Let us join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the Old and New Testament scriptures and according to the tradition of our Christian faith. Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit? We welcome you all into the body of Christ, represented on earth by this synodville, by this congregation gathered here today, and those who are viewing online. We want to say to you that kumnandi ukubala. It's nice to be here. It is nice, it is good, and it is blessing. As brothers and sisters, we live together and we praise God together. Go into the world and shine the light of God in anything and everything that you are, that you do, and that you will say. May God bless you, may God go with you, and may God give you all the presence. We are still inviting you. If it was normal, I would be creating holy chaos. People will be coming to come and hug and kiss and do all kinds of things. We are under COVID-19 protocols, even though it is a bit better, but we are still seeing the ugly head coming here and there. We are going to be welcoming you, and we are saying to you, you go out and you also invite others, that whosoever will may come. And this, Rakhadi, we are singing a cappella. There's no notes and there's no thing coming. There is only the words on the screen, both in English and in Sesotho. So we will sing those as they return back to their seats. Thank you for trusting Christ. Thank you for committing your children into the body of Christ. May the Holy Spirit go with you. Amen. Thank you very, very much. You may be seated.
Be seated. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you
for the moment that you have given for us to come together to witness your love, to see your call on the life of your people. Lord, we dispel all darkness by the power of the Holy Spirit, and we welcome them, each and everyone, into this service as the body of Christ, the one in Christ, who move and find our being in the living Christ, the resurrected Messiah, and the reigning Lord. We pray this, Lord Jesus, that your word will be heard in the hearts of all of us, that we will know and commit to you from this day afresh. Amen. We have read two scriptures. The first one was 1 Samuel 16. We read from verse 1 to 13, and we read the second scripture was Matthew chapter 3. We read from verse 8 to verse 13. The theme of the sermon today says, anointed as God's beloved. We read in the Old Testament of God sending Samuel to go and anoint David as the king. And David at this time was about 17 years old, and he did not look anything like a king. And I think we have seen this morning anointing and blessing and welcoming and baptizing babies into the faith in Christ. They do not look like anything like Christians. And it is our responsibility as this congregation, as those called by God, to help shape their lives, to help work against all powers of evil, to ensure that we can have adults who are Christians and young people who love the Lord. Let me just say that the life of David, and I think all of us as Christians gathered here today know something about David. The life of David was not perfect. The life of David did not only go smooth and problem-free, but the life of David is got wars and fights and battles and loss and challenges and conflicts like in any other family. So if you want to learn about the life of someone who remained faithful to God, who knew that the anointing that God has given to him, who accepted that he was the child of God, we read and you study the life of David. You will understand what it says. We hear in the reading, Samuel comes to Bethlehem, and he goes, frightened as he is, to go and anoint, which is to carry out that which God is sending him to do. God sends us into an ugly world. Samuel says, if Saul can hear that I am going to anoint somebody else as king in the time when he is king, he will kill me. It is a confession that says, we live in a world of those who do not want the word of God and the acts of God to be known and to be seen and to be heard in the world where we live. Yet God still sends us to those places and to do those duties as if God doesn't know that we are scared. So David gets anointed at this time, and we see that as he goes there, he's got preconceived idea or a picture of what kind of a person will be called, what kind of a person will God choose to be king. And God rejects six of them, seven of them. I'm not sure, I can't know where I can count, but he said they had seven sons. So God said to all the others, these are not the ones I'm looking for. He was not even there. He was not even counted as one worthy to be a king, even by his own father. So it is not anything new that you will be working against and you will be moving against the tide, that you, whatever you do, you will be challenged. Whatever you have to become, you will be challenged. So it is not easy, smooth sailing, that because we have baptized children today, because we have welcomed Lindokutle as a member, a full member of the church, that we have welcomed the people who are transferring into the society, that life is going to be easy. In fact, it is when you confess Christ that the devil comes out with all his friends and enemies and friend and family to come and attack you.
So Christ comes so that me
and you can have eternal life. But what Samuel is doing is what God has called Samuel to come and do. Samuel is called, go and anoint David. And Samuel, number one, is that David did not look the part. But secondly, is that David, even after anointing, did not become the king right away. It took time. It is only at around 30 years that he becomes the king. He had to go back after being anointed. He had to go back to the sheep to be a shepherd as he was.
So patience
works for us. Perseverance works for us. Waiting on God works for us. But here is a thing that happens. As we read, it says, then the blessings, the anointing, I want to read to you just as it says. So Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon David. Even if cannot be seen, even if you cannot know that it is there, the Spirit of the Lord is upon these children that we have anointed, that we have anointed in oil today, that we have welcomed into this church today. Baptism, as we have said the last 2 days, is a welcoming into a community of God. It is a mark that marks us from the world and claim us to be children of God. It is a baptism, as we're reading the Matthew reading, that it is a baptism of water that will become into a baptism of the Holy Spirit. It precedes the Holy Spirit. It comes with the Holy Spirit. It is within the Holy Spirit. So as we pour water, or we make a cross, the symbol of a cross on the foreheads of these children, as we welcome you, as we put you into the name of Christ and we call your name to put in the cradle roll of heaven, we are invoking the Holy Spirit and anointing you with the Holy Spirit. It is the Spirit of God that comes, and the anointing comes upon you as those who are called by God and those who are chosen by God. In the olden days and in the olden times, when kings and priests were called to service, when they are welcomed into what they are supposed to do, when they are proclaimed and exalted as those who are to lead, they were anointed with oil. So the anointing of water, the anointing, the baptism of water is the same as the anointing of oil. It is a symbol, the outward symbol that proclaims the inward spiritual things that God is doing. God claiming you to God's self. God calling you and God inviting you. And God saying, you are my son, you are my daughter, and I am pleased with you. It is important today to be reminded that the Spirit of God stayed, dwelled, and lived within David, even at the age of 7, even though he was not yet king, he was anointed as king. So these we have baptized today are anointed as children of God, as heirs with Christ, as a nation of priests, as the holy people of God. God says to Abraham at some point, I will make you into a nation. I will bless your name, and you will be a blessing to other people. When God blesses you, when God puts you into a special place like we've done today, welcoming this the people who are coming in here, baptizing the children and welcoming Lindo Gudle. It is in a way that God affirms you as God's child. God affirms you as the one that he trusts into this world. God affirms you as the one she can send you out into the world to reveal the glory of the Lord. So each and every one of us, hence the vows were always going back and saying, we also affirm our baptism and our covenant of confirmation. We come today to be reminded that we were once young, we were once baptized, we were once confirmed. But as now we remember that as a, as a, as a baptized, as a confirmed, as a member, there are things that you are supposed to do. In the Methodist Church, you say you take upon yourself the duties and the privileges of membership in a way of following Christ, in a way of living in your life modeled by what Christ has taught us. And Christ says to those he baptized, those he teaches, those who Christ calls, go ye therefore into the world and preach the gospel of God. Preach the good news. And St. Francis of Assisi says we must just use words if it is necessary. In other words, when we preach by the way we walk, we preach by the way we relate, we preach by the way we think, we even preach by the way we eat and by the way we drink. It is important for us as Christians to know that we are the chosen people. It is important for us to know we are an anointed people for a purpose. The purpose is to proclaim the name of Christ, to exalt the image of God in us and in each other, and to praise God for the gift that he has given to us by giving us other people, members of the church. We praise God for giving us your other members of the church. We believe that God has blessed us and God continued to bless us through other people. We pray, we know that God requires us to honor God, to honor himself, but also to honor those he gives to us as friends, as family, as companion, and as colleagues. But God also wants others to also honor us in a way that will give glory to God. So it is important to know that what God has given to us, what God has imparted on these children this morning, but through Christ's death, is that each and every one of us deserve to honor and worship God, deserve to relationships of honor, and also to be honored as an individual. We need to honor ourselves. The one thing that makes us fail most of the time is that we fail to honor our own words. That we are Christians. We believe in God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. We believe in God our parent, yet we discriminate against other people. We confess Christ as our Lord and Savior, Christ who welcomed the sick, who welcomed those who were different to him. He even lifted those who were weak, yet we are not willing to do that. We just want to live with those who look like us, who speak like us, who believe like us. It is important to be reminded that Christ welcomes everybody as a friend, welcomes everybody as family, welcomes everybody as a child of God. And Christ came so that me and you can have a right to eternal life. We have a privilege for each other to live in a way that will exalt the name of God, that will affirm the image of God in each and every one of us.
Of the Lord, saved and left in David forever. God does not take
back the spirit. One writing says, do not remove your Holy Spirit from us. God never removes the Holy Spirit from us. We move away from the Holy Spirit. We hide ourselves. We do things that will numb our consciousness, that will continue doing what is wrong. We stay, we come and baptize. We come and baptize children and never return to church again. We come and bring children to church. We don't come to church.
Especially fathers.
Fathers bring family to church and they don't come to church. It's a commitment for us that the church is full. It's for the first time today. So we must have baptism every day, so that we can have a full church on every day. When we are baptizing, people come in their numbers to come and confirm that, yes, Jesus Christ is my Lord. I love Christ. You will see them when they baptize the next child.
It is today the Spirit of God
stays upon you, whether you like it or whether you don't like it. But it is so well, and it is so joyous, it is so glorious, that you can come and say, yes, the Spirit of the Lord is still upon me. God has anointed me. As you work and as you do the things that you do, that you will can feel that I am the Son of God. I am the daughter of God. I am a member of the community of God. When you practice equality with others, when you ensure that justice happens to everybody, when you are through your activities and your relationship with others, ensure that those relationships enhance the dignity of other people. Husbands, love your wives and give them the dignity that they deserve. Wives, create in your homes the love, the environment of love that you and the children can live in peace.
The Spirit of the Lord was on David forever. And as I say, we know the
life of David. We know the problems that he had. We know, but also how God confirmed it. Here is the thing. We ascend in the world. Christ prayed the other time, one day, that I pray for them, that they are in the world, but they are not of the world. It is important, the choice that we have to make every morning as we wake up. I am in the world. I go into the world. I serve into the world, but not as that, as those of the world. If you remind yourself every day, you will give honor to Christ. You will do things that will promote the values of the kingdom of God. You will live by the principles of the kingdom of God. We all know that the basic principle of the kingdom of God is love. And the Bible tells us, if we could all love, sin will disintegrate. If we could all love, hatred will disappear. If we all love, prisons will be empty. We don't need for the government to build more prisons. We just need to observe our Christian rights, to affirm that we are in the image of God, and Christ died for us and made us holy people, that we are a holy nation. The bishop calls us to social holiness. We can never experience social holiness. We can never experience social peace. We'll never experience social justice if there is no individual peace, if there is no individual justice, if there is no individual dignity. One of us have got a role in life, starting in your own family, to teach your children,
to remind yourself, to be an example
with those you work with, that you are the image of God. Be proudly, you know, the thing that called proudly South African, be proudly Christian.
And God,
through the waters of baptism, as Christ was coming out of the river, and the word, the voice was heard saying, this is my son in whom I am pleased. I just want to remind you that Luke tells us that as Jesus Christ was coming, just after the voice of God said that, the Spirit of God led him into the wilderness to be tempted.
Temptation is not simple. Temptation is not wrong. It is falling into
temptation that is wrong. But Christians, we are made aware through the scripture. I've just given you Nokutla the Bible. If we read the Bible, it tells us into the Bible what sin is. We are told in the Bible how to overcome sin. Look to the cross. Look to Christ. Look to what Christ has done. There was a movement that calls itself, what will Jesus do? That every time when we have to make a decision as a daughter, as a son of God, we say, what will Jesus do? Or what will I say? What will Jesus answer me if I ask Jesus, do I do it or do I not do it? So we are conscious of what we do. We are conscious of the choices that we have made. We just have to make it.
Someone said,
we know what to do, what to do. We must just do it.
Nobody can
live our lives for us. Nobody can confirm for you that you are a child of God more than the word of God that says, you are my son, you are my daughter, in you I am pleased. I think God was supposed to ask the question, am I pleased in you? So maybe we could answer that question. And whatever we do, will it give glory? Will it please God as we do, whatever we do in our daily work?
You are the child of God. You have been called
by the name of God. You have been given a symbol on your forehead as a child of God. Christ sacrificed his life. And the mark that you put on your forehead marks the sacrifice of Christ and says to you,
not guilty of this charge. Live as a person
who is discharged from guilt.
Not like others, who they give
parole and they go back and kill. That's what we do as Christians. We are given the freedom to resist evil. We go back and do evil.
Christ calls us today. And the question is like
he asked to Isaac, to Isaiah, who will go for us?
Who can we serve?
We are sending these children this morning. And we are sending, we are committing ourselves as those who are sent by God. As we go home, we go as those who are anointed. We go as those who are called. We go as those who are affirmed.
As the soldiers and
disciples of Christ.
And it is in Christ that we are anointed as the beloved of God. Christ died that you and me can inherit eternal life. But eternal life starts on this earth. That when you can say,
then I saw the new earth and the new heaven. Because the old and the old earth and the old heaven has gone away. Today, the old heaven and the old earth is destroyed.
By our confirmation and our affirmation, as
we affirm with these ones who are baptized, as those ones who are welcomed, the power of God over our life. We go as those anointed as the beloved of Christ. Christ said at one time that what gift is it, that sacrifice is it, that a friend can give their life to their friends, as if someone can give their life to their friends. Christ did. You and me are free. We go into the world as those who are equal into the image of God, as those who are justified by the sacrifice of God, as those who are consecrated into holiness. So we can live and create social holiness. But you go.
You go as the flock of God, under the shepherd's God, guided and directed
by the one who loves us more than anybody else. May God bless you. May God be with you. And may God send us and we be obedient to the sending of God. In Christ Jesus we pray. Amen. God of all goodness, grace, and love, help us commit to follow in the way of Jesus Christ and to value our faith in him as our Savior and Lord of all life. Direct us to be your glory on earth by our thoughts, actions, conversations, and relationships.
We are going to
stand and sing the lyrics. I want you to listen to the lyrics of the song. And I want us to rise and really sing, who am I? And listen to what the lyrics of the song says, confirm you as.
That the Lord of all the earth would care to know my name, would care to feel my hurt. Who am I that the bright and morning star would choose to light the way for my ever wandering?
caring heart. Not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are.
Been claimed by Christ, who affirm that indeed we are Christ's folks. We pronounce the benediction together and we give glory to God. We say together, and now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us, unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. Go in peace, and may the peace of the Lord be with you. Amen. Have a wonderful week.
That the Lord of all the earth would care to know my name, would care to feel my hurt. Who am I that the bright and morning star would choose to light the way for my ever wandering heart? Not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. Storm in me, not because.